Simoni here for Spellbinders Paper Arts, and today I'm going to show you a video tutorial on how I created this paper cake.
I've seen a couple of these on Pinterest, and another designer, Michelle Warner, created one that was circular in shape. I wanted to have a little bit different take on this and decided to create a square cake. Now, one thing that you may not notice from the still pictures of this cake is that there's a surprise inside. So there's a couple of chocolate pieces there on the top layer, and then check this out. Woo! A whole bunch of chocolate. So this would be a really fun idea to do for a bridal shower. They could be party favors. You could use them on tables, maybe at the wedding rehearsal. You could really do a lot of different things with this. It's just a really fun project. Okay, so to get started, I needed to create the three boxes, and I chose to use my grand squares in three different sizes. So I used some Whirlwind cardstock. This color is honey, and I decided I wanted to put a texture on them. And so I'm going to use my new M-Bossabilities. This one is Elite. And I'm going to put each square on my M-Bossabilities, put it on my A base plate, then add my D adapter plate and run through the grand caliber. Now, two of your boxes are going to be a little bit larger than your M-Bossability. They're going to hang out over the edge. And so how we accommodate that is we're going to emboss it once, and then we're going to move the paper up and then kind of position the paper on to the embossability, move it around a little bit, and you'll feel it kind of slide right into the pattern. So then we're going to emboss the other half of that with the same sandwich with our adapter plate on top. So we're going to send that through and make sure that all of our boxes have this gorgeous pattern on them. Then I took my score pal and I made a score at 1.5 on each side, and you're going to do this for all of your boxes. Then you're going to take your scissors and you're just going to trim right here on each end to create these tabs. You're going to flip it over, put score tape on the corners on each of these. Then we're going to build our box by doing some folding. So we're going to fold the tabs in and the panel up. And we're going to do the same over here. Fold the tabs in and the panel up, and that creates the base of your box. You're going to do that for all three sizes. Now, basically, what we did when they're all taped is you just turn them over, and there is your box. Next, I'd like to show you how we created this beautiful scallop on each of the boxes. It really reminds me kind of cake frosting. So I just got my hands on these gorgeous stamps by Just Right. These are Just Right Clear, and these are the classic scallop borders one. You get three stamps in one set, and they coordinate perfectly with Spellbinder Scallop Edgeabilities Edger. So the first thing I did was put the stamp on my acrylic block. I loaded it up with a lot of ink, and then I stamped it on some cream cardstock about 6 times so that I would have 6 different strips. These strips are about 8 inches long, which is the same length and size as our scallop edgeabilities. So if you were at CHA or you happen to get your hands on a new Spellbinders catalog, you'll notice that we came out with 6 classic starter sets of edgeabilities. And then at CHA, you've got new choices. You get 6 different classic decorative inserts. And we have 2 new classic edger sets. And the one I'm using today is the classic edges one. After I stamped each strip, I laid them on my cut plate, which is a little bit of a backward sandwich. But the reason I like to do this is I can lay my classic scallop edger down and put tape on it and secure it exactly where I want it to cut. So then I'll put my B base plate on top and send that through. Now for this, all I did was cut. I did not emboss, but the edgers will emboss a nice edge if you'd like that look also. So we cut all of those and then layered them on to the top edges of the cake. And then we just adhered them with scrapbook adhesives, easy tape runner. Next, we're going to do the bitty blossoms. So the first thing I did was I cut and embossed them out of white paper. And then I decided I really wanted to get kind of a shimmery effect. And so I chose some misting spray, misted those. And then we're just going to take a pen, a pencil, the tip of some scissors, whatever you like, and we're just going to start rolling. Then I cut and embossed this butterfly. This is Wonderful Wings by Donna Salazar, out of some cream cardstock. And then I also just got my hands on this new Want a Scrap Bling. These Wonderful Wings bling coordinate perfectly with the Wonderful Wings die cuts. And it comes in a set of three, so I used this small butterfly right here. And it matches up just perfectly and looked so pretty. So I adhered that with some Beacon adhesive, zip dry as well. So we adhered the bitty blossoms and our butterfly on the top. And that's really all there is to creating this paper cake. It was a really fun project, and I hope you'll give it a shot.
So that's all there is to creating this paper cake. We'd love to see your take on this project. You can let us know what you've created by reaching us on our Twitter and Facebook accounts. Thanks so much for joining me today.